Hi, I'm Whitney Espich, the CEO of the MIT Alumni Association, and I hope you enjoy this digital production created for alumni and friends like you.
Good afternoon. Welcome, everybody. Welcome to the afternoon session of today's Tech Day. My name is Steve Baker. I'm class of 84 and MArch, Master of Architecture in 88, and I'm delighted to be your incoming MIT Alumni Association president starting 1 July. Really looking forward to it. One of the things that I'm most excited about is the opportunity to work with volunteers and association and institute staff to find ways to make sure that you, our alumni, are meaningfully connected and engaged with the institute and with each other. And Technology Day is a perfect example of that, and especially this year, where we're returning to the campus for reunions for the first time in 3 years, which is really exciting to be back here on campus this year. And in addition, we have people watching or participating virtually from around the world. So in all, just so you know, there are more than 12,000 people back for Tech Day and related events this year. So that's a huge thing. Congratulate all of you for coming. Wherever you are in the world, we welcome you back to the campus to drink from the fire hose. And I know many of you know exactly what I mean. So the Tech Day program is a perfect example of that. I hope you, many of you had the opportunity to enjoy this morning's session on aging and longevity. And this afternoon we have an amazing program featuring really an outstanding community, the MIT economics community, which has really been something worth celebrating, and we're going to celebrate with them today. To kick us off, I'd like to welcome to the stage Professor Glenn Ellison. Glenn is the Gregory K. Palm Professor of Economics here at MIT and head of the department. He earned his AB from that school up the street. Nobody's perfect. And he completed his PhD in economics here at MIT. Glenn's research spans, this is a mouthful, so you're going to have to struggle with me as I get through this. His research spans a broad range of theoretical and empirical analyses across a field of industrial organizations. His recent work includes analyses of the implications of consumer deviations from neoclassical optimizing behavior for firms and markets, and the design of performance of various online markets, and the efficacy of affirmative action programs. Wow, I can't believe I got through that. I don't even understand what most of that means, but I'm sure that Glenn is going to explain it to us. So please welcome to the stage Professor Glenn Ellison.
So thank you all for coming. I actually will not explain anything that I do on today's stage. I get to be here as the privilege I have of being the head of the Department of Economics, and we're going to have a bit of a celebration of the economics department. You know, I think department heads often start this by sort of going through the history of MIT economics and going back to just before World War II when Paul Samuelson arrived at MIT, and, you know, Paul essentially took advantage of anti-Semitism that existed at the Ivy League schools, which I guess at the time felt that you should not have more than one Jew on your faculty. Paul recognized that as an opportunity, really created in a very short period of time one of the greatest economic departments in the world at an engineering school. And you know, I guess I'm really here, though, to look at the present and really say I'm really proud that 80 years later, MIT still has the number one economics department in the world. You know, we have a number of recent successes. Since the year 2010, 6 members of our department have won the Nobel Prize, which I would point out is more Nobel Prizes than all other departments at MIT combined by a fairly comfortable margin. We also have a lot of outstanding young faculty. The American Economic Association gives out this award annually called the John Bates Clark Medal to the top economists in the United States under the age of 40. 5 of my current faculty members are winners of that award. All 5 were among the past 16 of those prizes awarded. And if people ask me, you know, like, what is it that makes MIT ranked so highly these days? Well, you know, it's, we have, following MIT's mathematical tradition, we have some of the greatest mathematical economists in the world. We have a tremendous set of economic theorists. We have a tremendous set of econometric theorists who are developing new statistical techniques. But what I think is really most important right now in this current world is that we have a tremendous set of empirical economists. And you might ask, what is an empirical economist? Roughly, you know, empirical economists are people who work with data, and they're really what make economics a tremendously exciting place to be right now. And I know that people may be skeptical and say, you know, how could it be an exciting day to be an economist? You know, the world is so polarized, so hard to cut through the noise. But what I think is really going on is, while it's more and more difficult to have an influence, the quality of work that empirical economists are able to do has grown so quickly that they are able to have a greater influence than they have ever had before. And, you know, if you think about it, we live in this increasingly measured world. You know, Google can hire thousands of engineers to figure out how can I take all this data about these people and figure out exactly what pair of shoes to pop up on their New York Times page to get them to buy a pair of shoes today. But what economists are doing is figuring how can we use all that data that's out there in the world that, that private firms and governments have to sort of shed insights on some of the world's great, most important problems and try to have insights that are so clear and so convincing that you can cut through that noise. So anyway, I brought today with me three of my empirical colleagues. First of them is going to be, you're going to hear from Nancy Rose. Nancy Rose is one of the world's foremost experts on antitrust and regulation, if not the foremost expert on antitrust and regulation. She's a former department head. She's a Charles Kinderberger Professor of Economics at MIT. And she also spent time as a Deputy Assistant Attorney General for Economic Analysis in the Antitrust Division of the Justice Department. So, and you know, great example of sort of combination of research and ability to impact the world. After that, you're going to hear from Dave Donaldson, who's one of my CARC medal winners. And Dave Donaldson is going to talk to you about international trade and its effect on income distributions. And then finally, you're going to hear from Josh Angrist, who is my most recent Nobel Prize winner. Josh is going to talk about the credibility revolution, which is what he calls this change in how empirical economics is done, and also give you a little bit of insights on elite schools and their role in America.
Thanks for joining us. And for more information on how to connect with the MIT Alumni Association, please visit our website.